Welcome back to the Digital Health and Wearables series. Today, I have another magnificent episode and guest leader for you. But before I go ahead, let me remind you to subscribe to the channel, check all the previous content there for you. Also, let me acknowledge our partners, our series partner, Fujifilm Healthcare, and our industry partner, Isaac Care. But let me introduce you to Cris Salinas. He's the Global Head of MedTech and in MedTech Advisory and Innovation at Salesforce. Cris, how are you?
I'm doing great, Joao. Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
Brilliant. Nice to connect again. I know we met, just a few months ago, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. Amazing how time flies.
That's right. And today we have a very interesting topic for you, the intersection of wearables and sensors and their role in the MedTech industry. And Cris, the first question that I have for you is, how are wearables and sensors playing a bigger role in the next normal for the MedTech industry?
Yeah, it's a great question. And it's interesting to see the evolution of healthcare or digital health, not only where it started, but where it's going. So a couple of things to consider here. More and more patients are actively seeking care from a remote perspective, right? We gave them the option kind of through the pandemic that we went through over the past couple of years, and that changed the way that their expectation is moving forward. If I can receive a care, whether it's at home, on an outpatient basis, it's going to be a little bit better because it meets their demands as well. Again, not every patient, it really depends on the disease state that's being managed. So when you think about wearables and sensors, it allows, from a healthcare perspective, the opportunity to continue to monitor and provide value and continue to look at that continuum of care and the impact you're having from a therapeutic standpoint. Now, this could be everything from diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, pulmonary diseases, you name it. If you're able to have visibility to what the day-to-day looks like for a patient, it gives you the opportunity, again, from a digital health perspective, to make modifications to that treatment plan the entire way through. From the moment the patient wakes up, as they're sleeping, when they're active, when they're moving around their home, or when they're at work, you name it, you get to understand a little bit better of what are those dynamics that might have an impact on the outcome that you're getting. So when you talk about this intersection between wearable sensors and the medical device industry, that's where they're coming together. Now think of the therapeutic aspect of devices and where they play today. How can you help complement that engagement to better understand what that patient is going through and ultimately the impact it's having to the disease that they're looking to manage? That's where that intersection comes into play. And we see this gigantic change that's occurring. We see more and more medical device organizations trying to capture and understand how they can play a bigger role after their device is either used, implanted, or continue to be used for, you know, certain disease states.
Yeah, brilliant. Yeah, wearables and sensors are very valuable. And you know, I'm an advocate of wearables, and they give, of course, a crucial insight about proactive healthcare and the things that you actually want to achieve. Thank you for that insight, Cris. And the second question that I have for you is, have you seen partnerships created between the MedTech industry and the payer or insurance companies?
Yeah. So there's one thing I've always talked about is kind of that patient-centric ecosystem that has been created now. You have the patient at the center, you have healthcare systems or payers, providers, insurance carriers, you name it, all kind of around that patient providing that care. On some of the resources that these clinicians have or physicians have when they're providing care to that patient, not therapeutic aspect, whether it's pharmaceutical, device, you name it. So partnerships that we're seeing, the capture of data is really important. And I think that's where the sensors and wearables component comes into play, because you're better to understand exactly what's occurring from that patient perspective. Remember I talked earlier about that continuum of care. Where do you play? What are you capturing when you're not there interacting with that clinician? This is when the patient is living their day to day. We saw a case that occurred, and you'll be able to find it. This was made public and it's online, but it was a partnership that was developed in the diabetes care market. I'll explain a little bit how. For diabetic patients, continuous glucose monitors are an option that they have, right? They have a wearable or a sensor, if you will, that's able to connect to their skin and they're better understand what the glucose levels look like on their day-to-day basis. And through an app, they're able to see the impact that not only meals, but activity and their therapeutics are having on their glucose levels throughout the day. Now, being able to capture this real time throughout the day as activity is going on gives the clinicians a better opportunity to better make an impact as to how they're going to treat patients that have high glucose levels. So what did we see? We saw that since glucose monitoring systems in some cases are specific for one type of diabetes patient versus another. In this case, we saw a company called Dexcom that has a continuous glucose monitoring system that was able to get data to show that there is so much value in type 2 diabetes patients to use a continuous glucose monitor because it gives them better control of their diabetes. They presented that information back to United Healthcare System where they created a partnership. And now there's a pilot program that's been rolled out where type 2 diabetic patients not only have access to resources, but have access to a glucose monitoring system from Dexcom because they were able to show that there's better control, which ultimately gives you a better impact to their overall health. So that's a perfect example of one perfect example where you see that partnership of the impact these devices are having with the insurance carriers or the payers that ultimately creates additional value to that patient in controlling that disease state.
Brilliant, Cris. That's actually a magnificent example of self-management and self-care using wearables. And you mentioned the data is very valuable. And wearables and sensors are crucial and perfect to be the vehicle mm-hmm. to capture that data and, of course, enable sharing and everything else. And the third and last question that I have for you is, what do you think will happen next in the medtech industry?
That's a great question. I think we'll continue from a medical devices perspective to evolve into more of a digital forward organization. When you think about medical devices overall, and here's what I mean. Most people from a commerce standpoint, how do I capture that product or how do I acquire it to arrive in my facility, have become much more and more accustomed to having more of an Amazon-like experience. So facilitating that e-commerce approach is going to be a big one. How can I go online? Maybe I have a portal, I can click, order, my products arrive. We know that from a healthcare perspective, they're becoming much more open to receiving medical devices, right? 2019, I think the numbers were something like 2%. That number, you know, jumped sky high, about 20-fold as we went into 2021. And that number will continue to grow as we move forward. It's easy for me to grab my phone, you know, place an order, have a device show up, or enter the right information that I need for a specific device. So that personalization of care. And even for the sales reps that are going into some of these hospitals or connecting with these clinicians, that they have the right information at the right time when they're engaging with them. And then the data capture on the back end, right? What is the impact that you're providing from a medical device perspective? Because it leads to two big opportunities. One, additional revenue streams, right? With services that may not have been available before that get you better outcomes, whether that's education support or some type of physical therapy at home, as an example, for some implantables. And then the other side is it gives you insights as to what might be missing from a next generation product. So that ultimately provides a feedback loop into your R&D space, which helps you better understand what are you going to add to that product that you're going to get ready to launch in the future. So when you think about the next normal in medical devices, it's this digital first approach, everything from the moment that you're engaging with your customer, understanding who they are, what their needs are, supporting those sales reps, empowering those sales and marketers to be able to go out there and connect with your customers with the right information at the right time. And then on the back end is capturing what impact you're having from a product perspective, because you might be missing some component that you did not know or were not made aware of that will ultimately help provide that next generation product. So those are kind of the big three things, and I'm happy to go into detail in the future with you to talk about them. I know you're always open to have that conversation. So happy to do so.
Oh, brilliant, Cris. Thank you so much. You know, I love this conversation. We could talk for hours, perhaps develop an hour on each question, you know.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Maybe we could create a series, you know, like a subject series. Anyway, Cris, thank you so much. I love that. You know, I have a big vision for wearables. Well, the wearables can change the world, but certainly they are changing the healthcare industry. Also, they are the crucial partner for the healthcare of the future that we are all designing. And you're part of that. I'm part of that, bringing people together. Partnerships, as you mentioned before in your second question, are crucial. Concrete examples, things are actually evolving fairly fast. Now I think, and I'm noticing that in the industry, things are started to happen. Because a few years ago, mm-hmm. we're talking, but not much was happening. You know, it was a mismatch, if you know what I mean. Yeah. But now things are evolving very fast. Cris, I want to appreciate you are here, your magnificent expertise, insights. I'm not sure if you watch the episodes, but I finish all my episodes in a peculiar way, which is not really a question. It's called 1 minute of fame. And you can mention anything. I mean, shout out to the company, colleagues, family, traveling. I know you have many interests. We have some interests in common anyway. So mention anything whatsoever to round up. Over to you, 1 minute of fame.
Yeah, absolutely. I love it. 1 minute of fame. So first and foremost, love to thank everybody from your audience that's out there that are actually going on and listening to what's happening in industry. It's great to see this community being built and folks exchanging information. That's ultimately what's going to help us and make us better moving forward. Big shout out to my family, my kids, Diego and Cristian, and my wife, Maria Luisa. They're phenomenal. So love them, as well as my colleagues, people that I work with on a day-to-day basis, you know, such as yourself, Joao. You know, colleagues are people that you work with on multiple different projects across the globe. So thanks to everybody, you know, Christoph and Jennifer and Ian and, you know, the folks from our healthcare side, Rachel, Sindhu, Dalton, Sam, and our fearless leader, Dr. Fatima as well. So big shout out to them and all the great work they're doing in the healthcare and life sciences system. From a travel perspective, you know me, I love to travel. I think the last time you and I got a chance to see each other face to face was in London, and we were able to have dinner, which was always great to catch up with friends. But yeah, looking forward to the next trip. Don't know where that one is just quite yet. When you think of leaving or going outside of the US, I did travel quite a bit within the US as well, but would love to kind of visit a couple of areas that I've not been to yet. So we'll figure out what we're doing from a vacation standpoint here further down the year. But there's my kind of short and sweet, you know, minute of fame there for you.
That's brilliant, Cris. I love that. And you talk a lot about people, which is brilliant. Healthcare is all about people. Life is about people. Business is about people, but certainly healthcare is all about people. Thank you so much for being in here. Cris, magnificent insights. Nice to see you anyway. Thank you so much for accepting my invite.
No, thank you. It's great to see you again.
Brilliant. I'm going to round up now to all our viewers and listeners. Make sure you subscribe to the channel so you can get all the regular content. Also, I'm going to post Cris' socials in here. Connect with him on LinkedIn or on social media. And finally, let's acknowledge our partners, the series partner, Fujifilm Healthcare, and the industry partner, Isaac Care. I'll see you all next week.